can't be in the video. Why? You punched me in the face last week. That hurt. Yeah, I said you dance like a grandma. That's not a bad thing. It's not like I said you dance like one of those balloon things outside of, you know, used car dealerships that are like... Oh, so you promise you're not going to hit me anymore, ever again. You're on thin ice, mister. Hello again. Ouch. This week,
Mr. Mains is on the couch.
Hey, Mr. Wasko. Glad to be here.
I wanted to share a book that encourages readers to determine their own personal unique talents. And the name of this book is Savvy by Ingrid Law. It's a Newbery Honor book. That means it was almost the best book. Yay, I guess. You know how adults like to tell you that you have your own superpowers and you can only, like, figure out what they are, and you realize they're really only talking about, like, the power of friendship or remembering somebody's birthday, and you're like, that's not a superpower. Uncle Charlie can do that, and he's asleep most of the day. Imagine if you really did have a superpower. Like, an actual superpower, not like, you know, how to eat a taco without spilling it on you. In Savvy, we meet a girl named Mississippi, Mibs for short. She's part of the Beaumont family. Now, the Beaumont family is different from every other family, unless you are related to Superman or Aquaman or Ant-Man. I just found out there is an Ant-Man. That scene, he seems like he got the short end of the stick. Like, yay, you're an ant. That's not as cool as a bat.
I had a roommate, Doug, who was Quail Man.
In this magical Beaumont family, once you turn 13, you discover what your own personal superpower is, or your savvy. Get it? It's the title of the book. See what she did there, Ingrid Law? Ingrid Law, we're looking at you. Now, until you turn 13, nobody has any idea what your superpower is. But it could be something cool. Like Mibs, her brother Fish can control the weather, and her brother Rocket can control electricity. And her grandpa Bamba could, like, move the earth around and, like, create canyons and mountains and valleys and mountains, and which is pretty cool. So Mibs, on her 13th birthday, is desperately trying to figure out what her savvy is going to be. Plus, it's extra important that Mibs find out what her savvy is because her father, unfortunately, has been in a car accident, and she's trying to see if maybe her savvy can save his life. She doesn't know what her savvy is. She thinks that maybe, perhaps, it's bringing people back from the dead. Or at least turtles.
Turtles.
So in this book, you have a crazy adventure where Mibs and her friends, they stow away on a bus, and you meet this really insecure bus driver who's having lady issues and mom issues, and he's selling pink Bibles, and they're adventuring their way across states to get to Mibs' father to see if she can save his life. Now, teachers, Savvy is action-packed with figurative language. Fantastic. It's a beautiful read. If you are a fan of well-written novels, Savvy is fun to read. Plus, Ingrid Law includes a lot of ridiculous words, like hobbledehoy. Yeah, I didn't know that was a word until I read it. Hobbledehoy. You know what that means?
Hobbledehoy, a clumsy or awkward youth.
Yeah.
Why'd you come to me?
Mr. Mains, if you could have any superpower, what would it be?
What do you mean, if? I could turn myself invisible.
What? That's so unfair! That's not fair!
How do you know you don't have one?
Maybe I do. Do you really think I might have one?
Doesn't hurt to try. All I have to do is concentrate.
I mean, alright. Just, I mean... I've never tried this before. Let's see.
That should be good. Ew, that's gross. Stop making that sound.
Whoa, that was awesome!
Oh, that is the stupidest superpower ever.
Oh, yeah? Oh, man, I can do anything! Out of control? I've never felt more in control.
Are you sure about that?
What? No! No! Prince! No. Prince.
Wasko, I thought we were a pal! else. Come on, we were just doing the You Can Do It video. We had to do the park one. Ah!